Hi, and welcome to the Wine Caves at Robert Foley Vineyards up on Howell Mountain. Today I'm introducing our 2010 Claret. Most of you who know our wines know we've been bottling Claret since 1998, when it started out as a Bordeaux blend. It then evolved into 100% Cabernet Sauvignon for several vintages. In 2010, I'm taking it back to a Bordeaux blend. In this wine, we combine 80% Cabernet Sauvignon with 19% Merlot and 1% Petit Verdot. We grow the Cabernet Sauvignon in the mountain vineyards up on Howell Mountain, as well as those on Atlas Peak and over on Mount Veeder. And then the Petit Verdot and Merlot are both grown up here on Howell Mountain. So it's kind of nice for me to go back to our roots in winemaking for Robert Foley Vineyards and reintroduce Claret as a Bordeaux blend, some of the best that I have in the cellar. As each of the ripening lots come in and they're fermented and then subsequently barreled, I watch the personalities evolve in barrels, and I know pretty much in the first 6 months of the winemaking which are the most expressive lots, and then I'll earmark those for the best, more serious blends for us, including the Claret. They're elevated in barrel. The Claret varieties are elevated in barrel in a combination of new, two-year-old, and then old neutral cooperage. So I can use that neutral, the wine aging in that neutral cooperage as a back blending agent for each lot, sort of a fruit preserve. And of course, you get a boatload of new oak from the new oak barrels. But each individual wine is crafted and balanced this way. And then at the end of the aging cycle, I'll pick my favorite lots, combine them to make the base Cabernet Sauvignon for the Claret, and then do the seasoning and shaping, the seasoning really with the Petit Verdot and the shaping with the mid palate that Merlot breeds into the wine. For me, it's very inspiring to watch these wines develop as individual wines from individual vineyards in barrel, and taking care to balance each one with the proper percentage of new oak and older oak. But when it comes time to blend them, we're really looking for a synergy, not only of aromatic marriages, but also of perfect fit in terms of texture. Because as a species, we feel our food on our palate. This is very important. You can have a wine that's almost perfect and then it just maybe has a harsh finish or something, but we're looking for the perfect balance, the perfect finish. The Cabernet delivers right really across the aromatics here with ripe black cherry flavors, and nuances of currant come in from the Merlot. The Petit Verdot, just a tiny, tiny bit, can change a blend. I mean, we're talking 1% here. That 1% gives me an aromatic complexity of wild violet petals. And on the palate, the Cabernet framework coupled with the Merlot mid palate are completely pleasing. And then there's a little lift in the finish from the Petit Verdot, which also drives the aromatics. I'm very excited to watch this wine as it bottle ages for the next 10 or 20 years. Once again here, we have the combination of the best elements for ageability in red wine. The alcohol and acidity are in perfect balance. There's plenty of extract without the wine being overdone by any means. Really looking forward to watching this wine age, and I believe its ageability is going to be measured in decades, 20 years at least.